Hi, welcome to my shack. In this video I'll show you how to build your own DAB Plus receiver. This design is completely open source. Both the software and hardware can be found on my GitHub page. For this radio, a nice enclosure is also available, which you can print yourself with a 3D printer. In this video I'll briefly explain the schematics, show you how to build the radio and how I installed it in a printed case. Let's start with the schematics. On the front panel we see in the center the ESP32 processor. Controls are done with two rotary encoders, one on the top, one on the bottom, and three buttons for slideshow, modem menu and info power. All are connected with pull-up resistors and decoupling capacitors. Of course there's a display, it's an ILI9341 display which is connected to the ESP32. And the connector for the mainboard is here. Then to the mainboard we have the SI4684 DAB Plus receiver here. Here we have the antenna inputs and some protection against static, and that signal is going straight into the SI4684. Of course we have the power lines with decoupling capacitors. Also here for the digital part, and we have the data lines to the ESP32. Here we have the power regulator for the 1V8 for the digital part of the SI4684. And here we have a headphone amplifier, it's the TPA613 OA2. It's a very simple headphone amplifier. Analog goes in, we have some decoupling, and audio goes out through the jack. It's all controlled by the microcontroller via SDI and SCL. And this is a very simple op amp for the Kinch output. It's a plain schematic for that. Let's go to the power input. We have our DC in jack, which can have 7 to 15 volts. And the power goes into a LM2596T5.0 step-down converter. This is an easy converter to use for through-hole type components because it's in a TO220 casing. Of course, we have the filtering for the outputs, and we have our regulator for the 3V3 rail. And on top we have the connector for the front panel with reset, master in, slave out, master out, slave in, the clock, the slave select, interrupt, which is not used in this project, but it's there so you can use it if you want. And of course the SDA and SCL lines. And we have the 5V output to the front panel. We start with the front PCB. We start with the lowest components and end with the largest. So we start with the capacitors first. Next, the resistor network. Pay close attention, pin 1 on the component must align with the marking on the PCB. Now it's time for the headers for the ESP32. To ensure they are properly aligned, it's useful to put them on the ESP32 beforehand. Finally, we install the flat cable connector, the buttons and rotary encoders. The front PCB is ready. We install the display later. Moving on to the main PCB. The SI4684 chip and SMD components have already been placed. The headphones amplifier is also in place.
These components were mounted by the PCB manufacturer upon request. Again, we built from lowest to largest, therefore we start with the resistors. It's time for the shielding for the SI4684 and surrounding SMD components. First, solder the taps at the bottom, then solder the sides securely. We place this immediately after placing the resistors to further protect these components. When soldering the SMA connector, it's best to start with a center pin. You can then center the chassis part properly. Check if it's straight and flat on the PCB, then solder the ground pins. When placing the electrolytic capacitors, pay close attention to the polarity. The negative side is marked on the capacitors. You will also find this marking on the PCB. Finally, we install the voltage regulators. Securely mount them on the heatsink first. Place them on the PCB and ensure that the heatsink fits well. Then solder it in place. All components are on the PCB. Of course, we'll inspect all solder joints. Now it's time for installation in the housing. Place the front panel of the housing on an elevation, such as using one of the caps. Then remove the film from the display and place it in position. Next, place the front PCB. Don't forget the four printed standoffs. We installed a small PCB for the headphone jack. Lastly, we solder the LCD to the front PCB. First, place the back of the housing before you install the main PCB. Finally, connect the cables to the front panel, place the housing cover and screw everything securely. The receiver is ready. Time for the first test.